School is done for the day, and 11-year-old Eli Green and his sister Emily are headed home. Although the bus drops them off at their house, there was a time when there was a concern for Eli's safety, even walking up the driveway. 5 years ago, Eli was playing at a friend's house when he was stung by a hornet.
I know it hurt a lot because I like cried a little bit, but if you put an ice pack on it, it stopped hurting, but then my throat felt like it was closing, so it just did not feel right.
He didn't know he was allergic. In just minutes, he had an anaphylactic reaction.
Anaphylaxis is a systemic response or a total body response to something that someone is allergic to. And the symptoms usually include some kind of reaction on the skin. We think about hives, itching, or red skin. Often when anaphylaxis is severe, it can involve upper airway obstruction or wheezing, and sometimes some GI symptoms like vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal cramping. And oftentimes the patients are very anxious and they feel confused. And it comes on very suddenly, usually in a matter of minutes. And if not treated rapidly and appropriately, can lead to death.
When I saw Eli, he was unrecognizable. And it took everything to just stop and to put a smile on my face and not to have the tears start falling down that this was my son. At the same time the ambulance came, they put him, you know, on a stretcher and immediately gave him some epinephrine.
Epinephrine is adrenaline, and it is absolutely life-saving. The sooner you can get the epinephrine into the patient, the more likely that patient will survive that episode of anaphylaxis.
Who is at risk?
Actually, everybody is at risk from birth all the way through to elderly. And the most common cause of anaphylaxis is related to food. We typically think about milk, egg products, sometimes different forms of nuts can make patients allergic. We also worry about medications and sometimes venom that can be caused by bee stings.
After about 7 hours in the emergency room, Eli was sent home, but that wasn't the end.
The medication wore off from the evening before. I didn't think anything that would even happen. And at that point, he couldn't breathe again. I had to call the ambulance and we went back.
After spending more time in the hospital, Eli was finally released with an epinephrine auto-injector kit. In Eli's case, an EpiPen, which he carries at all times in case he gets stung again.
I have this belt with my EpiPens in it, so I usually have it on me. And I usually go with a friend to anywhere if I need to go anywhere. So if I get stung, my friend can inject the thing and go run for help.
It's scary, and it's scary especially for my son because he was in Boy Scouts or Cub Scouts at the time. He loved the outdoors. So my first thought was, I can never leave him. I can't take my eyes off of him because I don't have the ability to control hornets, wasps, or bees, and so that was very scary for me.
I try not to think about it mostly because I don't want to start worrying like when I'm down in the meadow playing or down there thinking, oh no, I can't get over there. There's going to be a hornet there or something like that.
Eli is also undergoing immunotherapy. He receives weekly shots with a small amount of the allergen and hopes his body will build up an immunity so he can go outside and play without any worries. Holly Firfer, CNN, Atlanta.